presence of the Lord. Dear Lord, in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, dear Lord, Father of all, thank you for the precious time that you gave us today. Thank you for ways in which you provide for us all. For your protection and love, we thank you. Help us to focus our hearts and minds for ways now in which you are about to provide for us all. Inspire us by your Holy Spirit as we listen and understand. Guide us by your eternal light as we discover more about the world around us. We ask all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, good afternoon, everyone, or good evening naman siguro. Good evening, everyone. So this is our second asynchronous class. And I am discussing to you now the module 2. So before, first part of our previous part of our sessions are the different concept of the three modes of the transfer with the derivation of the of different cues of the three modes, the convection, conduction, and transition. Now, in module 2, it is the transfer of feet through a multi-layered or composite plane wall. In this module, you will learn to derive the heat transfer formula for a composite plane wall, draw the corresponding thermal circuit diagram of multi-layered systems or composite plane wall systems, compute the total resistance of composite plane wall, calculate interface temperature between layers of multi-layered plane wall or composite plane wall, then calculate a known thickness of insulating materials or insulation in a composite plane wall, compute overall coefficient of heat transfer, calculate the total heat transfer Q from fluid to fluid separated by a composite plane wall, and calculate the pressure differential between layers of a composite plane wall. So this topic is a very interesting topic or a very useful topic when it comes to designing of an air conditioning system. Like for example, movie houses, commercial buildings, offices, in which there is a solution of an air conditioning system, because we need to compute the heat transfer from the outside and the occupants in the building. Heat transfer by radiation, combination of radiation and conduction through the wall of the building. Okay, in the figure now, we have composite plane wall with three layers of material. So, two local layer of material. So, the left-hand side surface has a temperature T1, and the right-hand side surface here as a temperature T2. So let A is the uniform convectional area of the multi-layered wall. So since the temperature at this point here at 1 is greater than the temperature on this surface, the direction of the heat Q goes this way. Hindi pa ingon ang Q to the right. So, considering layer to layer, applying the principles of conduction heat transfer for a single plane wall from module 1, we can derive the heat transfer through a composite or multi-layer plane wall. So, in the diagram, there are three layers. So, therefore, there are three resistances. Our resistances, we have R1, R2, and R3. So, tuluka resistance, R1, R2, and R3. So, if we draw the corresponding thermal circuit diagram, we have this figure. where 1 and 2 are the two extreme points of the two reference points. So, temperature T1 here, ini T2, T3, T4, and temperature decreases from 1 to 4. Well, decrease siya from 1 to 4. So, using 1 and 2, using one reference point 1 and 2, Q is equal to the temperature potential T1 minus T2 over resistance R1, where R equals to L1 over T1A. Then, using 2, 3, so Q is equal to T2 minus T3 over R2, and 3, 4, Q is equal to T3 minus T4 over R3. So from those equations, evaluating temperatures T2, T3, and T4 in terms of T1, we can derive the equation Q equal to this one at 1 to 4, where this one is R1, this one is R2, and this is R3. So R equals L over KE in degrees Celsius per watt, provided that L in meters, KE in watts per meter degrees Celsius or degrees Kelvin, and A in meters square. So, from this equation, we can factor out 1 over E in the denominator. So, ito yung factor out 1 over E. So, we can write Q equal to this equation. Then, to this equation. 1 over A man siya. Or the total heat transfer conductive heat flow Q divided by the surface area A is equal to this equation. So in designing, some engineers for their convenience will design or compute the total heat transfer per meter square of area, because once you multiply this Q over A by the area, so it will give us the amount of Q or heat transfer in watts. So depending on sa o pila ang cross-sectional area. Example for a wooling, for dinikin ang wool with a total area A. For example, the on this side of the wooling na ay bintana. So the material of the window or doors is not the same as the material of the wall. So to subtract this area and compute Q, where A equal to the total area of the wall minus the area of the two windows and the doors. Then compute separately the total heat transfer area for this three, for these windows and for the door. Separate na to. Kaya kiniraman ang naay. Ang naay. Composite material. Kini mostly glass. Ba? Glass. Ang kinisya din ang door is wood. So, depende na sa design of the building. So, Q over A is the watt per meter square. Multiplied by the area will give us the total heat transfer Q. So, based sa figure, based on the three figure with three layers of material, to the equation, general equation, are this one. Then, from layer to layer, so T1 minus T2, initial to evaluate to T2 minus T3 to evaluate T3, and T3 or T4 to evaluate T4. So, atong i-layer by layer ang analysis to solve for the interface temperature. So, for this figure, the interface temperatures are the temperature between material 1 and material 2, kinini ang T2, o temperature T3 between material 2 and material 3. These are the interface temperatures. Then, for the temperature differential for L1, for material 1 is T1 minus T2, for the next material, T2 minus T3, and third, ang T3 minus T4. So, the inclination or the slope of this line, ini nga malang lines, for the temperature difference, depends on the type or conductivity of the material and thickness. Because if the conductivity of the material is very low, so the drop in pressure is high, low sad. So ang inclination niya, ang slope niya is the co of inclination. So for example, this one, so ang change in temperature between this layer and this layer, at this point and the in this interface temperature, Myra, because of the inclination of this line. So possibly the conductivity of this layer is high. So nana amay tabo for the slope or temperature differentials of the different layers. So for the interface temperatures based on the figure above, evaluate T2, this is equal to 1, and T3 equal to this one, and T4 with unknown as with known T3 equal to this one. So in general, we have question. And take note that temperature in Celsius is equal to the difference in temperature in Kelvin. Now, what if the multi-layered has a parallel layer of material? And for this case, we can apply the concept of parallel resistor in an electrical circuit, but from Ohm's law. So ma-apply ta to siya ang katong principles of parallel resistor or combination series parallel. So from figure, for this figure, material 1 and material 2 are parallel. So let R1 resistance of material 1 and R2 resistance of material 2, the total resistance is equal to this one on this one. Then the corresponding thermal circuit diagram is this one. So similar akang Ohm's law for parallel resistor or series parallel resistor. The next figure, combination of a parallel and series. So material 1 and material 2 are parallel. So material 1 has a resistance R1, then material 2 R2. So solving for the total resistance of these two material, parallel material, so equal to this one. So we have this one. Then reducing this one into a single R, kibali mo ni R12 na kibali R12. Or combination sa parallel nga atong gimong series. So actually, what are parallel resistance? So R1 equal to this one, then R2, then R3 equal to this one. Then for example, the other surface or both surfaces are in contact with the fluid, so there is convective resistance due to conduction transfer between this surface and the surface of the inside and the fluid. So between the aning of surface and the fluid in contact with the surface, kung naman sa galing din eh, nasay 1 over HA. Then if the heater, combination of radiation and convection, so the total Q before entry there is a combination of QR and QC. So we have compute this before QR, express na to ang radiation transfer in terms of convective transfer H, then add na to ang ilang two coefficients. So we have the derivation here, this one. tawag din siya magnesium coefficient. Then ang total ana ang combined S suggestion and sa condition. So for problems that involves a combination of two modes of heat transfer. So medyo magka-complicate. But for here, from this point up to this point, pure conduction. Okay, next is heat transfer from fluid to fluid, separated by a composite plane wall. So, there are three layers of material or composite wall. Then both ends or both surfaces are in contact with a fluid. So considering the temperature of the fluid in contact with the surface has a temperature Ti, which is greater than T1, and here a temperature To, which is less than sa T4. So temperature decreases this way from I to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 4, then 4 to 0. So this portion here, this one, here, is conduction. So the resistance is 1 over H times A. Then there, conduction. Resistance is L over K times A. So the expanding circuit diagram of this system, this system, with fluids on both sides or both surfaces of the composite wall is R, this one. 1, 2, 3, okay, 5 R's. 5 R's. Ri, R1, R2, R3, and RO. RO and I, 1 over HA, condition. From R1, R2, and R3, L over KA. So the total heat transfer Q from considering I to O is equal to this equation. Equal ani? I to O. Or in terms of R's, equal to this one. Or in terms of total R's, so equal to this one, where summation of R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus Ri plus RO. Then from here, if we factor out 1 over A in the denominator, so we have this equation. And we can rewrite this equation to this equation. Then to compute the heat transfer per meter square of area, E over tanah diri, so we have this equation. So ang denominator, 1 over H, L over K, wala na ang A. So for the R's, Ri, for the resistances, Ri, RO, R1, conduction. Or if we express generally the equation, general expression of the equation, Q is equal to negative delta T over the summation of 1 over HA for conduction plus summation of L over KA for pure conduction, or delta T, negative delta T over the total resistance R, or ang Q over A equal to negative delta T over summation of 1 over H plus L over K, or this one. So this total heat transfer Q can be expressed on the basis of overall coefficient of heat transfer. Okay, from figure, for the interface temperatures, from figure, T1, T2, T3, and T4. So we have this equation for the surface temperatures. UR1, ikadua, kadugangan R. Jadi, kadugangan, katulong na R. Abot din sa 4, at kapataang R. Ipay ka na sa U. So, on the basis of overall coefficient of heat transfer, total heat transfer Q is equal to U times A times the temperature potential, where U is called the overall coefficient of heat transfer. So for this equation, the complicated equation above was now simplified, diba? In terms of this, because of this U. So, U now is equal to substituting, using this, okay, this formula. Isa nga formula for Q. So, U now is equal to 1 over summation of H, 1 over H plus summation of L over K. And the unit is in watts per meter square degrees Kelvin or watts per meter square degrees Celsius. So, mag-Kelvin o mag-Celsius ang figure the same. Mana ang overall coefficient of heat transfer. So, for example, sa problem, given ang overall coefficient of heat transfer, then some of the parameters are unknown. So, you have to solve the unknown parameters or variables. Like, for example, the thickness, mostly ang unknown is temperature, the thickness of the material, thickness of layers of the composite material. For example, karon. For example, for material 1, thickness is L1. L1 ang kabaga. For example, if we replace this material by another material of different properties, so with a lesser conductivity, with the same heat transfer, so malay nasad ang atong what is the ma-change ang iyang temperature differential, ang iyang the what we call this one, the resistance of the total resistance of the material with the same amount of Q. Kaya sa source kayo, sa Q, gikan naman na din eh. So, ina na pag-design of a building walls. So for air conditioning calculations, we need to compute the total heat transfer Q from the outside and the heat infiltration, other sources of heat, and the heat inside the building to be air conditioned. So muna atong computon with application of transfer. For example, exposed sa usa ka building or tower of LDT tower nga naay thermal transition. So ina na, or exposed ba siya sa exhaust gas from an engine. Standby unit nimo sa nga makina nga gabugahan siya sa hot nga exhaust gas or asog. So that is an additional factor to heat transfer. So kinala na siya akong i-consider. Let's consider that one. So example, a composite plain wall is made up of an external thickness of brickwork, which is 10 centimeters thick, followed by a layer of fiberglass 8 cm thick and an insulating board 2.5 cm thick. So the L1, L2, and L3 are given in centimeters. So careful mo, kay centimeters ang unit. Now, the thermal conductivities of the three materials are as follows. The quark, okay na ang units. So, then I convert the quark, fiberglass, and the insulating board. The fluid film coefficient of the inside wall is 3.1, while on the outside is 2.5. Determine the overall coefficient of heat transfer and the heat loss through such a wall 3.5 meters high and 15 meters long. Take the internal ambient temperature as 15 degrees Celsius and the external as 28. So 28 ang sa gawas, ang sa sulod is so brickwork L1, okay. On a brickwork. So outside then O or O then I. So direction of the heat cube from the high temperature low temperature goes this way. So the corresponding circuit diagram is this one. 1, 2, 3, okay, 5 resistances. RO, R1, R2, R3, and RI. Okay, using Excel, so by inputting the values, so provided the unit was were converted. Ang meters, ang centimeters, na-convert na to meters. Convert na, tanong din L1, L2, L3. K1, K2, K3, no need conversion. So, HO and HI. Ang 1 over HO, L1 over K1, L2, K2, L3, K3, 1 over HI. Then, ang area, length times width, ang area. Then, 1 over A, 1.02. Then, ang sum na yun sa kining tanan, 1 over S, this one, equal to 3.21. So, in terms of R, mauni ang mga Rs. So, using Q equal to negative delta T over R, where ang delta T na to, 28 to 15, so, we have Q equal to 212.9 watts. Then, for the overall coefficient of heat transfer, the overall coefficient of heat transfer U equals a 1 over summation of 1 over H plus L over A. So, pure substitution ng yun. So, the overall coefficient of heat transfer is 1. 0.312. For the interface temperatures, you use these formulas. This one. Kung kaon ang interface, temperatures T1, T2, T3, T1, T2, T3, and T4. Or analyze the problems by considering layer to layer. So, gikan na mga po ang T1, T2, T3, gikan na from this equation. Okay, number two, a furnace wall is constructed with 25 centimeters of fire brick with a conductivity given 8 centimeters of insulating bricks, conductivity given, and 15 centimeters of building bricks. So 25, 8, or 15. So wala, the figure was not drawn to scale, kay nabaga na noon ang gagamay ang 15 kaysa 8. So wala may scale. So mao ni atong composite plain wall. And the inside surface temperature is 600 and the outside air is 30. The convective coefficient for outside air is 3.6. So okay. So what we need to convert is the length and thickness, thickness. Okay na. Then calculate the total heat transfer in watt per meter square, not pat U over A, the interface temperatures, and the overall coefficient of heat transfer. So Q over A. Using the formulas above to solve for Q over A and the overall coefficient of heat transfer U. Then for the interface temperature, interface temperatures are T2, T3, and T4. Again, using Excel, we have these values. So I will accept solutions using Excel. Dali ra. If you use Excel, okay ra. Why? No problem. Use a calculator. Whereas if you use Excel, input lang mo sa data, then derive, insert the formula to the cell or box of the Excel, then using the given data, you can now compute what is required. So this one is an Excel generated solution. Excel na siya. Number three, similar problem, sir. Ang number three, similar to one, pero ang area mo nag-different siya. Okay. Next module is module three. On this module, we are dealing with the heat transfer from the internal surface to outside surface or from the outside to the internal surface of a cylindrical material or pipes or tanks. If the internal surface is in contact with the fluid as well as the outer surface of the cylinder, so we can now derive, we can also derive the heat transfer from fluid to fluid separated by a cylindrical wall. So from figure, we have here a cylindrical or a cylinders with a length L perpendicular to the monitor. Considering that the inside surface temperature T1 is greater than T2, so the direction of the heat Q goes this way. Pagawas, ang Q. Pagawas ang Q. Now, let R1 is the radius, internal radius, based on the inside diameter. Inside diameter divided by 2 is the radius. Twice the radius is the diameter. So, and R2 is the outside radius based on the outside diameter. So, outside diameter divided by 2 is the R2. Then, difference of R2 and R1 is the wall thickness of the material. So, assume that the material, the cylinders or the cylindrical pipes has a conductivity K. Again, from applying Fourier law, where the radiant heat flow Q, or the conductive heat flow Q is equal to the product of the conductivity A and the temperature gradient dT over dx. So, in this case, heat flows in a radial direction. So, the area A is equal to 2 pi R times L. Because if we cut, mukata diri atong i-open dayon, so the result is rectangle. And this one is the circumference equals to 2 pi R times L moy ang area. So the area is 2 pi R L. So substituting A to this equation sa Q, then by separating variables, simplifying equations, then apply ang integration, we will arrive that Q is equal to this one. Step na lang. Pag-integrate na. And next. Diri. Then after ani, dr over r is ln of substituting limits ln of r2 over r1. Diba? Napa-ln ani ha? Wait ha. Integration then ln of R2 over dri. After dri, ln of dr over r. Pag substitute sa limits, nahimong ln of R2 over R1. So kining-kining diri Q QDR QDR over R. Okay, gikan diri paingon diri. Gikan diri paingon diri, then integration, then by applying integration mo arrive ta niya. So ang final is this one. The final equation is this one. And by rearranging terms, we have this one. So, rearrange. Or, we have this one. Okay, now, from this equation, for this equation, Q is equal to the temperature potential T1 minus T2 over ln of R2 over R1 over 2 pi TL. So, relating this equation to Ohm's law, voltage potential over the resistance R, so Q is equal to the temperature potential over the R. So, therefore, ang R equal to 1. Or, in general, Q, negativity ln of RO over RI, 2 pi TL or negativity over R. Then, for a composite cylindrical material, so composite, for example, a pipe with insulation, two or three types of insulating materials. So, ato ang buhak-buhakon, for example. So, from the center, so we have here the pipe material, the conductivity is K1. Kinisa mga yung pipe material. Then, followed by an insulating material, conductivity K2. Then, followed by an insulating material, conductivity K3. So, karon, net L is the length of the pipe perpendicular to the monitor. So, considering 1-2, ito ang reference point. So, similar equation katong sa above. Pag-abot sa 2-3, the ratio Ln is R3 over R2. Dito yung R2 over R1. So, pag-abot sa 2-3, 3-2, so R3 over R2. Then, pag-abot sa 3-4, ang ratio is R4 over R3. Then, the temperature difference, 2-1, T1 minus T2, dito, 2-3, T2 minus T3, because 1 is greater than 2, 2 is greater than 3, and 3 is greater than 4. Then, at 3 to 4, T3 minus T4. If the outer surface, if the temperature of the outer surface is less than, is greater than the internal, tato pa, ang direction of the heat Q, opposite. The same equations, but the temperature, mahimong, masuli ang mahimong T4 minus T3, mahimong T2 minus T2 minus T1 o T3 minus T2. But change ang iyang ang temperature difference. Then, ang direction is opposite. At tima niya, if the outer temperature is less than the inner, the direction of the Q is reverse. Reverse. So, expressing from 1 to 4, using the two extreme points, 1 to 4, so we have this equation. So this is now the R1, R2, and R3. So common ang 2 pi L, 2 pi L, 2 pi L. Common. So we can factor out these terms. Kanang 2 pi of L. 2 pi of L. So, atong ma-factor out na. So, hindi siya ma-factor out. So, in general, Q is equal to negative delta T over summation of R or Ln over ratio of the outside to inside over the 2 pi T L. Then, from here, ato i-factor out, we have this. So, yung factor out, 1. So, nabili diri K1, K2, and K3. Then, we can write this equation to this equation. So, nanaan 2 pi L diri. pi L. And for total heat transfer Q per meter length of pipe. So we have this equation. Because designers, most designers, they express that total heat loss per meter length of pipe. When multiplied by the total length of pipe, so the result is the total heat transfer Q. Diba? Mas mayo nga. For example, karon, you have a program or you make a program or Excel worksheet to compute for the total heat transfer of composite plain wall, composite cylindrical material. So, naa ka na data of Q over L depending on the material. So, input na nimo ang mga parameters, then na kay Q over L. For example, ang design nimo ang ipag-compute is 200 meters length of gas pipe. So, times 200, mo na ang total heat transfer Q. Q over L times the length of pipe is the total heat transfer Q for that pipe length of material. So, in general, so we have Q over L equal to this one. Now, for cylindrical pipe or cylindrical material with fluid in the inside as well as on the outside, the inner surface is in contact with an inner fluid and the outer surface ang sagawas in contact with the with an outer fluid na sa gawas and inside. Because usually in an actual application, for example, karon sa mga steam pipes sa mga planta, na steam pipes, mga gas pipes, na fluid flowing inside the pipe. So we have to insulate that pipe because if the temperature of the fluid in the pipe is very hot, so we have to insulate the pipe. So have to insulate so that the outer surface become the lower of the temperature of the outer surface after insulating the pipe is manageable na or tolerable. So next is the heat transfer from fluid to fluid separated by with a composite plate wall with an outer fluid sa gawas and inside. TI convective coefficient of the inside fluid and its OTO convective coefficient of the outside fluid. Now, the internal surface area inside is less than the internal surface area on the outside. Kaya ako masag diameter o radius. Ang inside, gamay o radius. So, R1 siya. And the outside is R4. Sa ito pa, the outside surface area or inside is 2 pi R1L. And the outside surface area is 2 pi RO times L. So, I to 1 is convection. So, yeah, we can use this formula. From Newton's law of cooling or heating. So, kini siya. In terms of 1 over, where R equals 1 over HI. Then, for the pipe material and the two insulation, so we have this one similar to the above equations. 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Then, at, napa, 3 to 4. Napa, 3 to 4. Then, 4 to 0. So, conviction na sa 4 to 0. So, we have these equations. So, where AO for the outside, AI for the inside. So, the total heat transfer Q is equal to the sum of the inside and the outside resistance plus the resistance of the three composite material in a cylinder. So, mauni siya ang sa tulo ka material, pipe material, and the two insulating materials, kini ang sa fluid inside, kini ang sa outside. Again, we can factor out 2 pi L from the equations. Ako i-factor out ang 2 pi L. Then, what remains inside the brackets are this one. Then, expressing perimeter length or heat transfer perimeter length of pipes. So, we have one. So, ang nakadugang, 1 over R1 from the above equation at the kadugang is ang 1 over R1 HI 1 over R4 SO. So, ang I kinahanglan pa pair siya or pare sa R1. Inside me, ang O saan siya sa 4. Di, pwede nga ma-change na sila nga RI SO R4 HI, no? Ah, di, pwede ha? Careful mo. So, you need to draw the system. Kumay mo, drawing nga ninyo ang system or ang figure. Bisag, cross-section lang, like this one. Then, indicate mo ang mga radius from the center to the internal up to the outer surface. Aron unsa nga ratio imong gamiton. Kaya, for 1, 2, R2 over R1. For 2, 3, R3 over R2. For R4, R4 over R3. 4, R4 over R3. Kung ma-reverse mo itong ito, temperature ang i-change and the ang difference. So for the temperature difference between layer to layer, so for I to 1, so Ti minus T1, so T1 minus T2, next T2 minus T3 and T3 minus T4 on T4 minus T4. So the thickness of the insulating material is on that conductivity or properties of an insulating material is an important factor in designing cylindrical pipes with insulation. So, na pipe nga init yapon ang outer space, oh, because of a poor insulating or poor insulation. So, possibly nigpaste or the type of insulation used dagko pa o conductivity. The common insulation in a in an aircon system and the industry for piping system or for pipelines lang asbestos, diastyro, there are many types of insulating materials from cable. Nakakaroon ka na ang murag, what type pa na o material, ka na ay murag sinaw sa sigarilyo used in mga stove or refrigerators. So if you go to the internet, you can search the different types of insulating materials with their corresponding properties. Yang density, conductivity, mga importante sa mga insulation, conductivity. So for example, karon sa mga cookware, mga malon ng mga cookware, kaldero or kaldirin or talaha. So, kinahanglan diyos a material that could that can withstand high temperature and high conductivity material. Aron ang kainit sa kalayo on the lower part, dali mo tulod. Init ka pong kayo ang on the other side of the pot or pan ba. So, kana sa in that case, dili man sa air conditioning or refrigeration, so, kato mga tag-as o conductivity. So, that's why nga, kung magamit na o katong kulon sa una, nga, kinini ang atong lungagan, kalas o kining heat. Because, ang katong kulon, gamay o conductivity. Gamay o conductivity. That's why for cookware, like for sa kanang mga indaydi na mga cookware, so kana siya dagko na siya o conductivity. So kanang ibutang nga po sa induction stove karon mga modern naman. So high tech na, so safe na ta sa ato mga pagluto because of that induction stove or heating. Minimal o kurinti. Okay, so example number one. Oh, excuse me, napatay. So again, the conductive or heat transfer from fluid to fluid within a cylindrical wall, insulated cylindrical wall, can also be expressed in terms of the overall coefficient of heat transfer, the same as a plate wall. So the Q now, the general formula for Q here, ang general formula na to, this one, three. So, equal sa negative delta T over summation of 1 over S plus summation of ln ratio of outside to inside over 2 pi KL. Equal to this one. Okay, equal to this one in general. So this Q is equal to UIAI times negative delta T or UOAO times negative delta T, where UO is the overall coefficient of heat transfer based on the inside surface area, katong 2 pi R1L, based on figure above. Then ang UO is the overall coefficient of heat transfer based on the outside surface. So kinang pare sa nila. Kung UI ka, AI. Kung UO, AO. So UI, AI is equal to UO, AO. So after solving the total heat transfer Q from this equation, equate Q to this equation to solve for the overall coefficient of heat transfer in and outside. So this U, O and I are now in watts per meter square degree Celsius or watts per meter square degree Kelvin. So the same ragapon ang figure bala Kelvin or mana ang overall coefficient of heat transfer. So compute Q based using the above formulas, then i-divide nimo sa AI times negative delta T. Okay, example. Water flowing through a cast steel pipe with a conductivity of 50 watts per meter square. So the pipe material is steel. If you go to table for conductivity of different types of material from your from our subject nga materials, engineering materials and testing, so the conductivity of steel pipe is something or approximately equal to 50 or 50 ba. So with an outer diameter of 104 and 2 millimeters wall thickness. Sato pa ang thickness is 2 mm. Calculate the heat loss by convection and conduction per meter length, of pipe with an outside diameter of 104 and an inside diameter of 100. So inside 104. So this one are the nominal pipe sizes. Pipes are specified in terms of the nominal pipe sizes. Dili gibaw ang actual. Because pipe of the same nominal diameter have the same, with different material, have the same outside diameter. That standard decision was developed by ANSI or American National Standards Institute in US in order to interchange fitting. Na kung mag-manufacture ka karong pipe, dinis Pilipinas, Japan o China ba na ang nominal diameter pareha, pareha gid sila og outside diameter regardless of the inside diameter or wall thickness. Nara ang metabo. Okay. Okay, from figure, ang given na to, HI, K1 given, SO given, then ang R1 is 0.05. One up of the inside. Then R2 is 0.052. So AI, 2 pi RI times L, ang L per meter length man, so consider ta nga ang L equal to 1. Then we can compute sa dayon ang AO. Then TI is 15 and the outside temperature is negative 10. So the inside fluid, which is water, has a greater temperature than the outside nga angin. So possibly ni siya winter ni siya. The water side emitting coefficient is 30,000 watts meter square Kelvin. Okay. Check na ang unit. Wala na problema sa conversion. And the side is 20 watts per meter square degrees Kelvin. Okay, check na. Calculate the corresponding heat loss with the pipe is slug which is having an outer diameter of 300 millimeters and thermal conductivity of 0.05 watts per meter square. So, mauni atong ang first figure, this one. Ang mauni first figure. So, evaluating Q using the formula, na fluid diri sa taas, then R2 over R1 lang ta. So Q is equal to negative delta P. So negative 15 plus 10, so may mong 5, so mayroon naman 25 ang atong temperature. 15 minus negative 10, so ma-plus na din na siya. Then, 1 over HI AI plus LN corresponding heat loss in the pipe R1 over 2 pi K1 having an outer diameter of 300 real pipe raman. Then, plus 1 over SO AO. So, the Q is 163.1 degrees Celsius. Evaluating R, 1 over HI AI, RI, 1 over SO AO, RO, and ln of R2 over R1 over 2 pi K1 L mao ang R1. So, mani ang ilang mga R. Then, for the second condition, na naasay insulating material na nahimo ang outside of 300 having ang outer diameter of 300. So, again, nadugangan o ang K, nadugangan o sa ka-K. Dua na kabuk sila. Then, ang R1.05, R2.05, then R3 now, equal na sa kanya 300 naman, so kato nga 150 or 0.15. Then ang AI 2 pi R1L, ang AO 2 pi R3 2 pi R3L, then TI 15, then ang outside is negative 10 Japon. Kaya di pangita calculate kayo Q per meter length. Okay. Now, so 15, then negative 10, so Q equal to negative delta T over Q over L equals 2 pi negative delta T over 1 over H I plus ln of R2 over R1 over K1 plus ln of R3 over R2 over T2 plus 1 over HO. You see this formula? This one, no? Q over L. Kanara. 1 over RI, R1, HI. R3, kato siya R3, HO. Then ratio da yun. Na pi R. So 1 over H. So, the Q now, per meter length, or assuming a 1 meter length of pipe, or per meter length, is 163.1 3.1. Oh, 7.3. Ah, 7.3 na. 7.3 watts per meter length. Then, for the R's, so pila ka R? Ri, R1, R2, and RO. Upat ka R. So, Ri, R1, R2, and RO. Where R's, 2. So, use this equation for R's. Inisya. Then, RO. Then, R1 and R2. R1, R2 naman ba? 1, 2. Okay, R1, Ri, R1, R2, and R2. The total is 3.43 degrees Celsius per watt. Then, Q, 7.3 watts per meter length during 160. So, unsa ni tabo? With, by insulating the pipe with this type of solution na conductivity nga 0.05 o gamay kayo 0.05 conductivity na gamay ang iyang loss. Gamay. So, that's all for today's session. So, next meeting, next week, next meeting, next week in A31A3A. So, class pa na to. Today is 15. Uy, prelim naman dahil sunod ba? 22. So, next week is prelim. So, so asynchronous ta next week. Prelim exam. Coverage na to. Taas na ba? Plain wall. Post-it plain wall lang siguro. Or, depende lang. Ha? Basta, therefore, the prelim exam, just study the module 1, 2, and 3. Ato module is 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, di, di. 4 na. Kay 4 naman din siya. 4 na din siya ron. September 15. Okay. Let me check ha. 4 na ba niya? Buti na dahil. Up to module 3. Module 3. So, muna itong coverage for the prelim exam on next week. So, module 4, ang module 4, ready naman siya module 4, ang module 4 is heat transfer through spheres. So, sa mga spherical material or object. So, wala na nila bota ang module 4. So, up to 3. Okay? So, for your attendance, okay, I will check the attendance again. 3. So, may call on Apos. Is Apos around? Apos? How about Bag-aw? Bag-aw. Bag-aw, Apos, wala na niya. Absent, Bag-aw, absent, Apos. Then, Dalundunan. Hello, present, Dalundunan.
Present, sir. Present, sir.
Present, Dalundunan. Okay, present, yes, Dalundunan.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
Dumangkas. Present, Dumangkas. Makabinlar. Makabinlar, Kevin. Present. Now, Kamilar. Ay, pamunis mag Kamilar. So, sila, okay lang. So, the red text, ang red, no, na siya ang mga early bird, ha? Na yung mga deduction sa puwet sana. Then, Oclaret. Claret. Oclaret. Absent is Oclaret. Pamisa.
Present,
Pamisa.
Present, sir.
Present, Pamisa. Sumagya. Absent ni Sumagya. Okay. Then, Venezuela, Justin.
Sir, present, sir.
Venezuela. Present.
Present.
Okay. Bilaren, Kyle.
Bilaren,
present Bilaren. Okay. Okay, you, so so the total attendance is 36 out of 40. Satu pa 30-40 for were absent in the session. So, ang percentage na to is 90%. So, okay siya. Ah, okay na yun. Okay. Any question or clarification with the topics of two modules? So, medyo maya complicated ang curve surface ha, or salindrical because of the LN. Ang pinwall, okay lang yun kayo ang pinwall. Composing, bahala sila ka to. But for salindrical, medyo complicated. Okay, any question or clarification? Or any concern? If you have no concern, so you can now log out or